I'm Hunter Shepard from Minnesota Bulldogs. Finna take off on spaceship. Y'all need some like Matrix. And finna let she nameless. Cause the last two was too famous. We got that trophy like a champion. Fell asleep right on the jet. We gone. Big range just like a champion. This is Everything College Hockey.
Welcome back to our second episode of Locker Room Talk. Today we're in Amsoil Arena, the Duluth Bulldogs locker room with senior captain Hunter Shepard. Hunter, how are you doing today?
Good, how are you?
Good. Hunter, what does it mean to be a captain on the team and after winning two championships? Let's go ahead.
It's kind of an honor, I guess. The guys that I've played with the last few years, the guys that have been captains, have been obviously a huge part of this team and this team's success. And they kind of exemplify what it is to be a player here and be part of this program and how to represent it. So I just hope I can carry it on the best I can.
Being from Grand Rapids, you said you're a Gopher fan growing up. What does it mean to play against them and not only play against them but beat them?
That's great. But at the end of the day, all I can really care about is winning games for this team. And,
absolutely. How about this fan base? Obviously, you being close to here too, and being able to play in Duluth has got to be an advantage for you. And maybe you have family come to visit you and watch your games. Is that something special?
Yeah, I mean, it's a big hockey town. So it's,
right.
That's kind of the big thing around here. So many kids like the youth programs and just Northern Minnesota. Pretty much all my family lives within an hour or two, so for them to kind of be a part of my career here has been really special.
Absolutely, absolutely. Growing up, who was your biggest influencer? Who got you in the net?
Adam Hauser, he was a goalie for the Gophers in 2002 and won the first of the back-to-back national championships. And he lived right 4 or 5 houses down from me and went to his mom's daycare.
Sure.
So that's kind of the reason I started playing goalie.
Absolutely, absolutely. If there was another position you had to play, what position would you want to play?
I honestly don't know. I think I might have played baseball if I was a goalie.
Oh, really?
Very much so.
Cool, cool. 2 summers ago, you got to go to development camp with the Wild. What was that like, being a Minnesota kid?
It was cool. I tried to use it. It's kind of a learning experience more than anything. I think kind of get to pick the brains of an NHL goalie coach and kind of see what their guys do on a daily basis to get where they've gotten. And, experience,
where does the name Shepdaddy come from?
I did not give myself that nickname just for. kind of kids started calling me that in middle school, high schoolish, and it kind of just stuck.
What does it feel like to be everyone's dad?
I don't know, on this team, it kind of feels like it sometimes. We get so many young guys, obviously, a lot of talent in the locker room or whatever, but I don't know, I kind of feel like I'm getting.
Being a guy with experience, as a senior, you're the captain. What are you telling the guys, who are coming in, how to go win another national championship this year?
I don't think I'm the kind of guy necessarily to say a whole lot. Leading by example is more my thing. Just kind of having my routine and sticking to it and knowing what works for me and just kind of preparing and showing those guys needed. For the teams that they can make for themselves, just getting prepared on a weekly basis to be ready to play on the weekend.
With talking about routines, I mean, that you're going to be in net most likely every night. Does that help you out as far as preparing for the weekend series?
Yeah, it's nice. I mean, it's nice to know your teammates and coaches that have confidence in you. You can kind of just go and play your game. They know I go out there and battle every night, so it is nice to know that if you have a bad game here and there, you can be right back in the next week.
On Father's Day, do you and your dad go back and forth wishing each other happy Father's Day? Game to routines, what does it look like to start it on, say, a Friday if you have class?
Well, we have pregame skit at like 11-ish, and then pregame meal, pasta, chicken, pretty standard. I go to Diet Coke, take a nap. Mm-hmm. And I'll get here probably 4:30, 5 o'clock, take my stick, do the team warm-up, ride the bike, 5 minutes. Can I do it?
Are you watching film on the other team all week, or?
I will watch, you know, clips, their offensive clips from the week before usually, and then I'll watch the clips, chances against us with the goalie coach early in the week.
Why Vaughn? Why do you choose them?
My favorite NHL goalie for a while has probably been Jonathan Quick. And I was on him when I was a kid, and I got to high school, my dad let me get a pair. Took the first pair of customized pads I got to get. So besides the strapping, it's basically the same pad and golden blocker that I've been using since 10th grade. So it kind of just worked for me, and I've stuck with it for a while.
Do you wear your rings under your trapper or your blocker?
I don't take them on much, though.
What's being said in the locker room before every game? Who's speaking up on the team, or is it just coach?
I mean, obviously the coaches.
Yeah.
I mean, here for every game, but Wolfie's, you know, he's pretty vocal. I think that kind of complements us being captains together. I think, obviously, I'm not the most vocal guy, so him being kind of on the other extreme of things, I think it balances out well.
Now that you have, you know, some of the defensemen have a couple years of experience and won a couple championships, does that help you out when you're in net, knowing that, you know, you're confident in them and they're confident in you, and your chemistry's better now?
Yeah, I think obviously the style we play and the talent I have around me and the talent we have in the soccer, not just the defensemen, but the forwards, that's playing the defensive style that we play. I think it's a whole team. It's not just the guys in the back end, which, I mean, they've been unbelievable the last couple of years, but we just don't give a lot of chances. So, I mean, when we're playing our best, we're going to be playing really good for them.
Right, right. You're on the ice. Do you chirp at all?
Not really. You know, kind of just...
Keep to yourself?
Yeah, I try to keep to myself. I don't think we're right about that.
Right, right. You got the guys in front of you to protect you and whatnot, so... is there any pressure this year to get back to where you were? I'm sure every year there is, but I mean, is there any added pressure now that you've won it two times in a row and the target's on your back?
I wouldn't say pressure. I think I'm just such a competitive person. It doesn't matter what I'm doing, I want to win it. I think it's kind of just most of the guys on this team. So it's not fair to the guys that came in this year to base our season off of what we did last year. We're a new team. We had new guys, and we're kind of just going to move on from that and try to make our own identity.
Absolutely, absolutely. What was it like winning those championships? What's the feeling like? Are you in the zone the whole time, or you have butterflies?
Yeah, I mean, that's why I came here.
Right.
I mean, it was the only place that gave me an opportunity to come play college hockey at. That was an amazing conference, so, and the possibility of a chance of playing for a national championship and to play in one and win one, be in three and
right.
Win two, it's more really could have ever expected from here.
As a coach, what does Sandlin mean to you, and what vibe does he bring to the room in the rink every day?
It's all about hard work. Prepares us really well. I mean, watch a lot of video, and it's a hard working, just kind of blue collar style of hockey. I mean, I feel the prettiest all the time, and we just found what's worked for this group of guys over the last couple of years, and not have a 50-point guy every year. It may not be flashy, but he just really knows how to get guys to buy in and just do whatever we have to do to win games.
Absolutely. Especially 2 years ago, you had a pretty young freshman, or, you know, lots of freshmen and just a young group in general, but, you know, he definitely directed you guys in the right direction. Obviously, you won two championships. Is this year, is he just saying, do it over again, or is there anything specific he says?
I mean, when we went into the handshake line after we won last year, he kind of gave me a handshake and a hug, and we were both just like, well, let's try and do it one more time. I mean, that's always the goal, but
right.
I wanted to come back, and I just, you know, after my freshman year, they could have easily went out and got another goalie to transfer in or something to me for the job, but I kind of just wanted to show that loyalty back to them, this program. You know, obviously all the guys on the team are pretty close with. Just kind of want to finish it out.
Sure. Who's the funniest guy on the team?
probably Nick Swain or Dylan Savage, pretty close.
Yeah.
Dylan's kind of goofy. Swain's is more of a dry humor, but get some good laughs out of those guys.
Absolutely. You look around the room, who's the last guy you'd want dating your sister, one of your sisters?
Probably all of them.
All of them.
Maybe Kobe Roth. He's probably the most innocent guy I've ever seen.
Yeah.
He's probably the only one I'd give the okay.
What's your favorite barn to play at, other than this one?
You know, obviously, we're all famous at the next
right now. Right.
As far as how big and fancy. I do like playing at Western Michigan.
Okay.
It's, you know, it's a little bit older, I think, but like, it's pretty nuts in there. So that's, you know, as far as that goes, that's one of my more fun things for that.
A couple hours before the game, what are you listening to?
All kinds of stuff, you know, country. So that's a lot of that until I get to the rink. And then I have my headphones in. But I usually just listen to the radio. It's about a time I get here.
Right. Who gets the ox in the locker room?
I think it's Kobe Bender. I don't even know. I'm sorry.
Sure. You're still in the zone, yeah.
I usually have to tell the kids go on and learn skates, but I'm not really allowed to touch the ox.
When you're at a visiting barn, do you hear the chirps or do you pay attention to them at all?
I mean, you hear them obviously, but
right.
I think over the years, but it's been 2 years in high school, or even now, it makes me play better at times. And, you know, like the kind of hostile environment. And I think just with the attitude that this team has, I think a lot of guys need to grab off that.
Right. Preparing for those championship games, do you prepare any different way than you would for a regular season game? Obviously, it's a bigger game, but is there anything special that you would do
for those games? No, I don't think so. I mean, you try to keep everything the same, try to kind of stay in a routine. And, I mean, obviously, what you've been doing has been working for you, so just kind of try to keep everything the same for everyone.
Obviously, your goal is to play in the NHL one day. Is there anyone other than Quick you model your game after?
I don't know. Just maybe Memphis, Bobrovsky's. I never had a goalie coach with you on them, so you know, watching guys like that, kind of just taking little things here and there that you like and kind of try it out. And kind of, it's kind of that's what helped my game, especially in the younger years.
Away from the rink, what do you do? Do you watch a lot of hockey or do you find other hobbies? Or?
I mean, I watch some hockey. I really try not to.
Yeah.
I love to hunt and fish. The town that I live in is like hiring people, so that's pretty much all there is to do there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, I just got home from golf. Kind of
okay.
Mostly what I do.
You get anything?
We saw one, but
no.
It didn't work out first.